Hello friends, we'll discuss an example on false position method, which is also known as regular falsi method, and its formula is x is equal to a into f of b minus b into f of a divided by f of b minus f of a. Here a and b are the two intervals, and f of a and f of b will be the functional value of the interval. Okay, so first I'll try to trace this real line where it is a is equal to and b is equal to, which we are going to calculate. Okay, so let us see what will be the way to get a solution for this one. Let us adopt the method of false position method. Very first we will take it as, we'll take the given function. We can see the given function is cos x is equal to 3x minus 1. But when we take it as f of x equal to 0, then automatically we will be getting cos x minus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, therefore it is cos x plus 1 minus 3x. Since this example is having a trigonometric term in it, so as I told you, please try to keep the mode of the calci in radian. Okay, first ensure that the mode of the calculator is radian. That has to be ensured. That is very much important now for the calculation part. Okay, so let us take the function f of x is equal to cos x plus 1 minus 3x. Then we'll try to trace out the values where they lie between a to b. For that we start with 0. If you put 0 here, then what we get? Cos 0 plus 1 minus 3 times 0. We all know the value of cos 0 is 1. So 1 plus 1 will be equal to 2. Therefore the value of 2 is positive. Means we got value of 2 is equal to plus 2, that is positive. Next we take 1. When we take 1 here, then the calculation part we can see. If you put 1 here, then it becomes cos 1. We'll take cos 1. First we'll ensure the mode of the calci must be in radian. Okay, it is in radian. Okay, now we'll calculate. Cos 1 plus 1 minus 3 times 1. So that is equal to minus 1.46, which is less than 0, means negative. Therefore the root between positive and negative is possible. Therefore we write down the root lies between 0 and 1. Now we need to check it out whether in the neighborhood of 0 or in the neighborhood of 1. We can see the magnitude of the functional value is 2 and minus 1.46. So irrespective of the sign, it is 1.46. And this number is very close to 0. Therefore, next root can be expected in the neighborhood of 1. Okay. So we start taking the values. A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. And the value of A is positive. The nature of B is negative. The root lies between positive to negative. Means between positive and negative, that is 0 to 1. But we feel this magnitude is very high, so lengthy. So searching between 0 to 1 is a bit difficult for us. If we get the difference between B to A is less, means B minus A, if I get a very small one, that is very good for us to search next real root between positive and negative. For that, what to do? Let us take 0.1 difference from expected root. What is expected root? Expected root is 1. So from here to here we take. So that is 0.9. So first we calculate 0.9. That is f of 0.9. Let us see what is f of 0.9. That is cos 0.9 plus 1 minus 3 times 0.9. So that is minus 0.078. It is negative. So this is negative. So between 0.9 to 1, it is not possible. Then what to do? Next, take again 0.1 difference, that is 0.8. Let us see what happens. Cos 0.8 plus 1 minus 3 times 0.8. That is equal to minus 0.70. Means when we take f of 0.8, we got minus 0.70. Still it is less than 0. Means negative. Again, it is not possible between these two. Next we take again 0.1 difference. 0.1 difference means we take 0.7. Okay, let's check whether 0.7 is positive or negative. So again we substitute these values in the function. Then we get cos 0.7 plus 1 minus 3 times 0.7. That is f of 0.7 is equal to minus 0.335. Still it is less than 0. Means this is also negative. So it is not possible between these two. Then we take 0.6. Let us see what happens with 0.6. So f of 0.6 we are going to calculate. Then it is, let us see, cos 0.6 plus 1 minus 3 times 0.6. So that is equal to plus 0.25. That is equal to plus 0.025. Okay. Therefore, since it is a positive, so the root is possible between negative and positive. So this is positive. Now we cannot expect between these two. Now the expectation will be between these two. Therefore, the real root lies between 0.6 and 0.7. Okay. Now we'll use these results to calculate next approximation. Then we know that regular falsi method or false position method is having a formula. X is equal to A into F of B minus B into F of A divided by F of B minus F of A. So this we are going to take it as a equation number 1 to calculate the value of X. Okay. So let us substitute. First approximation. In first approximation, as per the formula, what is required? A is required and B is also required. Then the functional value of A is required, functional value of B is required. Okay. So let us see. A is equal to, the root lies between 0.6 to 0.7. The small number I'll take it as A. Then next number will be taken as B. And the value of A as 0.6, the functional value of this is already calculated, that is 0.025. Then f of B at the rate of 0.7 is also calculated, that is 0.335. Okay. Therefore, substitute these results to get next value, that is x1. X1 is equal to, what is x1 here? A into, A is 0.6 into the functional value of B, that is 0.0 0.335 minus value of B is 0.7 into the functional value of A is 0.025. This divided by f of b. F of b is minus 0.335 minus 0.025. If you calculate this result by using a calci, this will be 0.607. This 0.607, if you consider, then this will be treated as x1. Okay, so it is, I'll trace it here again. It is 0.607. Now we have to check it out whether it is positive or negative. Therefore, f of x1 that is equal to f of 0.607 is equal to, let us see what it is. Cos of 0.607 plus 1 minus 3 times 0.607, that is equal to 3.62 into 10 raised to minus 4. Into 10 raised to minus 4 means this is equal to 0.00036. Since it is positive, so it is greater than 0. Therefore, at the value of 0.607, the functional value is positive. Positive means now it is not possible between 0.62 point this. Now it is possible between these two results. Okay. Therefore, the real root lies between 0.607 and 0.7 now. Okay. Therefore, second approximation. Here we need A as well as B, f of A as well as f of B. A will be 0.607 and B will be 0.7. And the functional value of 0.607, which is already calculated, that is 0.00036. And the value of 0.7, the functional value of 0.7, which is already calculated in a previously, that is minus 0.335. Therefore, x2 is equal to A into, what is A? 0.607 into f of B, that is 0.335 minus B, that is 0.7 into f of A, that is 0.00036, divided by f of B, that is minus 0.335 minus f of A, that is 0.00036, which is equal to, if you calculate this result by using a calci, it is 0.607. This is the value of x2. If you compare x1 and x2, we got same results. So 0.607, 0.607. Therefore, we need to conclude here. How do you conclude? The required real root is 0.607. This is the answer. Thank you.